For the first time since the Ukraine war started, China's President Xi is set to meet President Vladimir Putin in Uzbekistan tomorrow. Beijing's top diplomat revealing the two allies aim to take global order, quote, in a more just and reasonable direction, close quote. Here to react and talk about the Ukraine war, former U.S. envoy to Ukraine, Kurt Volker. First, Kurt, could you tell me what you worry most about as these two allies get together?
Well, I think sanctions avoidance is one thing, that the Chinese can help the Russians evade the financial sanctions, take some of the pressure off, and maybe get Russia some of the spare parts and critical components that they need, like microchips. That's something that I think is worrying. Military support, I'm less worried about, because I think China's pretty circumspect about getting dragged into this.
So far, since the last time we spoke, we have the Russians begging Iran for drones and asking North Korea for rockets. And now we've seen a confirmation of between 2,000 and 3,000 square miles back in Ukrainian hands. They are on the offensive in every sense. Can you bring me to the battlefield?
Yeah, and I was just in Ukraine last week, saw some of this firsthand. I think that the Ukrainians have got good people, great morale. They're defending their homeland, so they're really motivated. Good training and good equipment from the U.S., and they're putting these long-range artillery systems to good use. And the Russians are just the opposite. They are poorly motivated. They don't really want to fight in Ukraine, the soldiers I'm talking about. They have poor equipment. They've lost about a half of their conventional military capability in this war already. So when the Ukrainians were fighting in the south, the Russians went there to defend, and that opened up the north, and the Ukrainians just pushed out from Kharkiv, took a significant chunk of territory. And that's going to be the pattern we see going ahead, Ukraine gradually rolling back the Russian gains.
I mean, they have not had much gain since April, when everyone thought Ukraine was dead and buried. And now we see a pushback in Kherson, but there's only 400 miles there. Will it be easier going in Kherson as they have to shift troops, you would imagine, to fortify in the north?
Yeah, I think that it's going to be tough in Kherson, no question about it. And the Russians are certainly shelling there and shelling Mykolaiv, which is nearby, mercilessly right now. But what the Ukrainians have done, very smart, is isolate the Russian forces that are in Kherson. They're caught between a river and the Black Sea. And the Ukrainians are trying to keep them isolated, make sure they can't get supplies, keep pushing the pressure on, and eventually they're betting the Russians are going to have to pull back.
It's so important that Ukraine prevail, because if not, Georgia, Moldova, pressure on the Baltics would have receded. Ukraine is fighting for more than just their country, and I hope the rest of the world realizes that. Kurt Volker,
exactly right.
Thanks so much.
Thanks, Brian.